Today we are commemorating the 75th anniversary of the last flight of Ian Willoughby Bazalgette, who was posthumously awarded the Victoria Cross. Of course, Ian lost his life in 1944 on August 4th, trying to save his crew members. He was flying a crippled Lancaster. The Lancaster had just been on a bombing mission over Trossy St. Maxim, and in doing so, he was attacked by anti-aircraft fire. That anti-aircraft fire set his starboard wing on fire. That knocked out two of his engines. A little while later, we wind up with engine number two down. So he is now trying to fly this four-engined aircraft on one engine. He's trying not to crash. He's ordering his crew members to bail out. He decides to stay with the crippled airplane, trying to bring it down so that he can rescue two of his crew members that are mortally wounded. He tries to set it down in a meadow just outside, but the aircraft was so badly damaged. There was fuel leaking back into the back of the fuselage. He'd already lost the majority of the lifting surface of the right wing or the starboard wing. So when he sets it down, all the crew member other than the two mortally wounded ones had already bailed out. They bailed out at about 100 feet. That means they jumped out of the aircraft, pulled the ripcord, and hit the ground. It was barely time for their parachutes to deploy. When Ian set the aircraft down on the ground, he must have known the odds were against him when he even decided to do that. In fact, he ordered the last member of the crew before they bailed out to secure his crash harness around him tightly so that he could stay with the aircraft. Upon touching down, the aircraft exploded, killing all three members. So today, when we're running it, we're going to run all four engines, and then we're going to shut it down with just engine number one. That's the furthest to the east. And it's going to be running in the same configuration that Ian struggled to keep that aircraft up. Think about what it would be like if you were the pilot. You are struggling to keep your aircraft. You are thinking ahead to, how do I get my crew members out? How do I find them? I've got an aircraft that's on fire. What are my odds? That's what probably, I think anyway, would have been going through Ian's mind as he was trying to set that aircraft down. Certainly, he could have decided to abandon ship with the rest of his crew, but he elected to try and stay with the aircraft to rescue him. And it was that bravery, that self-sacrifice, that posthumously won him the Victoria Cross.